As educators, your job is academics, not morals, not values, religion, political ideology, or anything outside of academics.
I've heard, like everyone, anecdotes around the country of left-wing indoctrination in schools. And people would always tell me, oh, that's just an isolated incident. Don't worry about it. Well, it's hit home for me now.
We were silent when you took away our medical and religious exemptions. We were silent when you mandated these masks. We were silent and some unaware when you began mentioning sexual preferences in kindergarten. The first day of school that my daughter goes, her teacher tells her that white is the worst race there is.
Children do not come to school to identify their ideologies. They come to school to learn to become productive citizens.
I wanna quote Mr. Gipe, and I'm quoting, I scare the fuck out of him. Okay? That is child abuse.
This is evil. It's darkness. It is hell. And these are criminals for abusing our children. They're principals. They are principals. They are co-conspirators. They are accessories, and they are principals in this crime.
Who filed the CPS report? This needs to be done. CPS and a complaint needs to be filed to the district attorney.
He's not teaching for the student. He's teaching for himself.
It is your responsibility to know what he's teaching. And it's been going on for years, and you allowed it to happen. That tells me that you're not even following your own governing board, your own rules.
When Common Core came out, we let you slide. When all this sexual ed came out, we let you slide. I don't think there's time for any more.
And you guys, you're gonna be held accountable. This is because of you, okay? Gabriel Gipe is a symptom, not the sickness. The sickness is in the district. It's in the school. It's everywhere. The people are sick of it. We're aware of it. We know what's going on, especially now, and we know what you're doing, and we're not gonna let this go. You can't just fire this one guy and then just call it quits, and it's done. It's not done.
I happen to be one of those parents whose daughter was in this class. The first thing that he said to them, to the students at the beginning, the same thing that he said on the video. I have 180 days to turn you guys into revolutionaries. That's how he started the year, okay? Now they asked him, what's going on? He said, I can't tell you anymore. He said, I don't know you guys yet. So from the very beginning, he planted the seed.
For the fact that my 17-year-old daughter had to come to me and said, Mom, you don't understand. Let me explain. This means that in 2 weeks, in 13 days, he was allowed to change my daughter's mind about some fascist crap that y'all have let in this school.
Let me tell you, I'm not shocked. Why? Because there's another teacher right down the road at Leroy Green Academy who did the same thing to my son.
These kids are formative. It's time for them to start their individual creative thinking and not follow some psycho and become a useful idiot for a communist party.
When you feel this pain right here, it's not going away. The only question I got is, where does the fucking buck stop? There were so many red flags. The man had an Antifa flag behind his desk. He had Chairman Mao in the fucking corner.
Hello, everyone. I'm Bobby. I'm a sophomore here at Intercom. I go to school here. I am under all of your instruction. Socialism takes your health care first. They own your body. Second, they take your education. They own your mind. This needs change. This needs change now. I don't know what else to say, but you all need to rethink all of this.
Is there Breyer and Hernandez roll call without objection?
Do you feel uncomfortable yet?